Hi, my name's Buddy, and welcome to my art room. It's actually just my spare bedroom in my apartment. Behind me are some of the paintings that I've done recently. I started doing the acrylic flow technique in April when I stumbled across Lily of Lily's Mix on YouTube. I had bought some acrylic paints to paint a friend of mine. Painting for, and I had not picked up a brush since 92. Anyway, I used to paint with spray paint and tempera paint and just was real creative but never really devoted much education or any time really to it. Just whenever I got the nerve or got a wild hair, decided to paint something. But usually if it stands still, I'm painting it. This is going to be my first video that I'm going to post. I have other videos that I recorded, some with sound, some I didn't say anything, but mostly what I do when I'm painting is I put my iPad off to the side and I'm playing YouTube videos of artists, and I need to give props because I've gotten a lot of my inspiration, a lot of my education from other artists that are on YouTube that had the courage to get on here as quickly as they did and soar, and they are just amazing people. So Lily, thank you. You kind of opened me up to this. You're an amazing woman. Will Black, you're just cool. I don't know any other way to say it. You are so comfortable with who you are and your life. And anyway, and then there is one of my personal favorites, and that is Annie's art. She is, Annie, you're great. And then there's Rick Shadell. Wow, dude. You can pump out some artwork and quick, and you don't even say anything, and people still subscribe to your channel. I really enjoy watching yours. When I'm having a really bad day, I need to calm down or something, I'll just put on one of your videos, and I'm just like, oh, it's like Valium. Also, Anne-Marie Ritterhoff. Woman, you crack me up every time I watch one of your videos. I like your frankness, I like your honesty, and I like your take me as I am or don't watch me attitude, and that's awesome. And I also like the fact that you're very professional about the way you do your videos. I tend to gravitate towards people who do their videos being themselves, which is why I haven't posted any of mine, because they were all staged and everything looked pretty. And if I was to take this iPad off the table right now and show you what this room looked like, I'd be embarrassed. So, without further ado, I'm gonna pause this. I'm going to set things up because I'm doing it right here where I'm sitting. we'll get to it. All right. Hope you like what you see. Okay, this is one of my paintings that I did earlier, not today, but probably did in May. And I even made the frame itself. It's out of recycled wood from an old futon frame that somebody was throwing away, and I grabbed it, and I've made several frames out of it. And this is actually done on wood. But this was a month after I started, so it's not that difficult to do. But it is a lot of fun. Set this aside. Okay, so what I've got going on here is I've got a 16 by 20 inch canvas, not an expensive one. I've put my push pins in the corners. I got a little dirt on it a bit ago because this room is really small, so I really have to navigate very carefully. This is Blick Cadmium Yellow Medium Hue. This is Cerulean Blue by Artist Advantage. The orange is Artist Advantage. And the green is Artist Advantage. This is Cobalt Blue, and that is by Folk Art. And I can't remember what the red is from, but I did these earlier from a painting I'll show you here in a minute, or when I'm done with this one, that I did kind of a flip and drag, and then did something strange at the corner. I like the way it turned out. So what I'm doing now is just checking my consistency. This one is still good. I had plastic baggies over them. And if you'll notice my cups and my sticks, I wash everything. So right now I'm just checking the consistency. And this one I am going to do, I was going to do a black background, and I may still do it instead of the white. I keep all my black and all my white paints already pre-mixed and ready to go. And I'll buy the large containers of titanium white, and that's usually Artist Loft or Golden if I don't want to eat the rest of the month. But yeah, so this one is good. What I'm looking for is a steady bead coming off the stick, no breaks in it, and hopefully no lumps. I'm also looking at how it falls back into the cup as well. See how it just kind of, it doesn't pile up, it doesn't do like a meringue would for a pie. I don't know if you can see that or not. There you go. So this one's still good, that's perfect. And then my orange. And I was gonna mix another color, and I think I still might. I know this looks like a lot of colors, but just bear with me on this. I want some metallic in there. So I'm going to use the Craftsmart Rose Gold. And let me get a cup. We'll do this one. So I'm gonna use about that much. And everything that I don't use, do that, I'm gonna add some Floetrol. And my pouring medium is three parts PVA, one part water. And then I always mix in the Floetrol first. I do this a little backwards. And sometimes I use silicone, sometimes I use water with dish soap in it for the cells, and sometimes I do both, and sometimes I don't do any. I don't think there's any right or wrong way to do this technique. I do what works for me, and I do what I get results. So, well, art is art, and to each his own. You know, if I'm happy doing this and it works, and I like the results, that's what counts. So, I am going to use a little bit of silicone to dust into my cup. Thanks, Will, for showing me that. And I'm redoing, and I don't care if the canvas gets dirty, it's going to be underneath paint. So, and that comes to my next point. It's just paint, y'all. Just paint. You can redo it. I tried the theory of don't give up on a painting. Never sacrifice a painting. Keep going. Really? At some point, I'm just going to grab me a spatula and scrape it and go over again. So, just more fun that way to me. So, I'm going to start off. Let's see. I've got silicone in all these colors here. The waters are good. I've already put silicone in them, but I like putting little bits in there. Now there, 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 and yeah. And I think I'm gonna do black instead of white. And I won't put any silicone or just water to soak it in with my white or my black. And like I said, this is already pre-mixed. I'm just gonna check the consistency real quick. And that's pretty good. So I'm gonna start off with that. And this is Artist Advantage Lamp Black. And it's already pre-mixed. I'm gonna put a little splits just so I can get some separation in there. And then since I like the metallics to really show up, I'm gonna put a little bit in there first, but I forgot to stir it up. And I just give it a couple whips like that, just to get it going. Go like that. Set that aside. Then what I really want to come through is probably the red, and then I'm gonna go with the cerulean. Yeah, that'll work. So next to the copper, I'm going to put my red. And I'm gonna do it right at the level so it doesn't mix too much, so it'll stay there. And as I get further towards the top of this cup, I am going to go ahead and start pouring it higher up. Thank you, Anne Marie. This is such a pretty color, I love it. I'm just going right down the center. And then, so that's going to make purple. I'm going to go with orange, because it's going to contrast against that. We'll see what happens. I'm not going to use a lot of this orange, because orange tends to take over a painting if you use too much of it. So I'm going to go like there. Just want patches of it. And then I'm going to go with the cerulean blue. It'll be really good next to that. Uh-oh, did I forget to stir that orange? Probably. Just paint. Just paint. So I love this color. Now I'm going to start letting it mix a little bit more. Now for some green, and I'm going to put some yellow on top of that. Notice I don't have much green left mixed. Then a little bit of the black. And then we're going to do some copper again. lots of metallics in my paintings since I discovered them. Then go with some yellow. Then go back to some little bit of red. Mix up that silicone a bit more. I'm gonna put it over to the side though, get it over here. Because I'm gonna take this all the way up. Because I like to make sure that I have enough, and I do waste quite a bit, but most of the stuff when I, underneath here's a plastic old shower curtain, well, a shower curtain that I bought new, but now it's old. And I let the drips dry, and then I peel them off, and I make jewelry. I'm actually wearing a necklace that I made. Make pendants, keychains, whatever suits my fancy. A lot of fun. As far as I know, it needs a little bit more silicone. Let's see what happens. Green, that's gonna be about enough green. Then a bit more yellow, take it up the side there. Because I have no idea how this is gonna turn out. I know what it's how to expect it to. I never try to predict. I think that takes the fun out of it. I try to control the composition quite a bit, but at some point you just gotta let go. If you want to keep the painting, just let it go and let it happen. Okay, that's good enough for me. So I'm gonna have lots to put away. That's fine with me. So I'm gonna do this flip. And I'm going to flood the canvas with some black. Come on now. There we go. That's a pretty thick black. It's really weighing that canvas down too. I've got to put my support in it. I can do that right now. I can do that with the cup in there. Oops. So this is my support. This goes lengthwise. It's already been cut to match. And I beveled the ends, see? So that it doesn't hurt the canvas any. Go right in there like this. Side to me. Go ahead and angle. It just kind of snaps up underneath there on the ledge. And I'm going to put this in widthwise, and it will push that right back up again and support that cup. And I've got a set of these that I've made for just about every size canvas that I've ever used. I've gotten so good at that I can do it when the cup's even on there, because I often forget that stupid thing. It's not quite centered. Going down. Is that attached? Yep, we're good. We're golden. Okay, that looks a lot better. Now, I'm going to get my fancy, fancy spatula here. Actually, I'll use one of these. This just seems to work quicker and better for me. And since it's black, I'm not that concerned about it. But I don't want a ton of paint on here. I just want to cut it. So, anyway, I'm just pulling the paint away from the middle here and pulling out the edges, getting to go over the edges a little bit so I can get the ends covered. And I'm also doing this really fast because I don't want this video to be hugely long. So in one of my videos, I did a 3 foot by, like 3.5 foot by 3.5 foot painting by myself, pour technique, in my kitchen. That video is over an hour long, and it took me all that time, and it turned out amazing. And then another one that I did right after that was like 2 3/4 feet by 2 3/4 feet, and it's out in my living room on an easel. And it's beautiful. It's on a big canvas, which is on wood as well. Let me get this out of my way. Okay. And whatever doesn't hit the edges when it goes over, I'll use a paintbrush. But I do like the way that paint turns out when it's all ribbed like this and uneven. But it doesn't like to dry very well like that. So I try to get it as even as I possibly can. But you know, a lot, it's got Floetrol in it, so it's going to level out some. it's funny when I'm out and about and I see something that would probably work as a good tool for painting, and I don't care if it's on the ground or whatever, or for sale, and if it's free, it's even better. If I think it can be used, I will use it, and I'll figure some kind of use out for it. Alrighty. It's one good thing about being creative. You can always see the beauty in something. Even if it's something ugly, you can just see it. Okay, let's go here and go like that. Come on now. Okay. Alright, I'm probably going to end up doing that. Okay, so if you notice, I've left a little bead around the bottom of the cup, because the way I'm going to pull it, I'm going to flip some of that black back on it. So it'll cover some of the color that's in there. I can't see that side, so I'm not going to worry about it right now. I can always get it later. All right, that looks pretty good to me. So, yeah, that's not bad at all. I was just checking to see how much paint was on there. It's not bad. Not bad. And it's starting to leak out. Cool. And it's going to show up real well, too. You watch. Because I know some of you are going, black. Well, I like black. It's one of my favorite colors. And I've had real success with them, so. I'm running up a bit right there, but I can get that later, too. I'm just going to get it. Thank you. Good man alive. There we go. Pull just a little bit of you this way. All right, you want to play? Go this way, then. I'm just making it worse, aren't I? Here we go. Okay, we'll set that right there. Alrighty, so here we go. Well, what do you think? That's gonna be flipping beautiful, pun intended. I'm a dork. I even recycle my gloves. I just wash them off and turn them inside out. I used to work in surgery, so I know how to turn gloves inside out really quickly. I can also hit a garbage can from completely across my apartment if I aim right when I'm taking them off. Alrighty. Oh, that's going to be pretty. I think I'm going to let it sit for a second or two. No, I'm not. Well, who am I kidding? I don't ever let these things sit. I got to play with it a little bit. I'm going to put you away right now. I'm not going to need those colors, so I'm going to go and get them covered up while that's doing its stuff. I'll just use those little snack Ziplocs. I'll leave my stick in there. It does just fine. Just zip it up to the cup. And then I actually have hair ties that I put around there instead of band-aids instead of rubber bands. Set that behind me on my little table. There it is. It's still going. Making some great cells. I don't like to torch unless I absolutely have to. It's just not one of my gigs. And A, I live in an apartment, and this is my torch. So, and I've had that since April. And it's but I have a replacement, just in case. Alrighty, let's see, what was I doing here? I'm really nervous, y'all. Beyond nervous. I don't know why. It's not like I'm bad at this. I don't think anybody can be bad at this. Like I said, it's just paint. That turns out real pretty sometimes, and sometimes it do not. Then scrape it. Or you can be a hero and just stick with it. Make it pretty again. I like to watch Will recover his. He always does a great job with that, but he stays calm. I panic and want to get the F out of Dodge. Bottom line. I'm short a baggie. Oh, that means that baggy gremlin has been to my apartment. Oh, there it is. No, my mind is just feeble. That's what it is. There we go. Boink. Done. Now let's play with some paint. Alrighty. This I want to lose. I know that's all copper. I get that. But I want it down this way a little bit more, so I'm going to let that flow real slow. Towards the other edge. And another trick is you can put your hand, pick up your canvas like this, and let the weight of it move it from the center real slow. See how it's doing that now? That's a really good trick, but I want that to go over that way. That is flipping beautiful. Wow. And stop, because I have a nifty little gadget that I made. I don't want to lose any more of that paint. So, I'm just going to do this. I don't care if it goes off the corner. There we go. And, booyah. That's going to make some pretty jewelry, because I'll even let it dry on the paper. Because I put mine on wood. I paint a lot on wood, too. So what I'm going to do is turn this around. That's a lot of paint on that paper. Perfect. And now, I want to go back the other direction, but where do you? There you are. I was making a painting for my niece one time, and it was a huge canvas, too. It was like 30 by 40. This was probably in June, and I was photographing it after it was done, holding my phone over it, and I dropped the phone right in the middle of the paint, just destroyed it. It's kind of funny. Not many people laughed, because there was nobody in here to see it happen but me. Nothing would hurt, nobody was hurt, just my pride. And that was an expensive faux pas. That was a lot of paint. I'm actually kind of digging what's going on. Stretch those out too much, so I'm just going to do this again. That gets it moving. Now I'll get paint everywhere. I don't care. Washes off. Those colors are amazing. That's just too much copper in one spot. Bring that back down. I do like negative space. I really do. Look at those blues and reds that are coming up through. That is amazing. I love it when this works out well. Good. Go off. Gotta watch these cells over here, though. Come on back to daddy. Okay. Come on. Good. Now go. Good. Stop. Now let's come back this way. No. Yeah. Come on back. I am shaking like a leaf. I don't know why I don't shake when I'm not filming it. Okay, I'm bringing this all back. And I think I'm just about ready to call that done. Because it's still going to develop a lot more, and I'm not going to have to torch it now. This is amazing. The cells that are developing in there and will continue to develop, mind you, for at least 45 minutes after this is. Oh, shoot. Oops, that was stupid. Oh well. As Bob Ross used to say, there's no mistakes, just happy accidents. And I used to watch him even as a child. I was the only one not out playing kick the can or whatever it was they used to play in the neighborhood. I was always inside watching Bob Ross on Sunday afternoons. That was one amazing painter. And his son is just as good. So, judge all you want. I am a Bob Ross fan. And we'll dye one as well. Let's see, we're going to do black on that suit. Give me that black back. Just in case I need it. By itself. Yes. Right there. So I need to cover up that little oops. Like that. Black is very forgiving. So is white. I had pretty good success doing the negative space with white. I've I just have really good success, period, usually. I really have to. I've only had to scrape 2 paintings since April. Seriously, I'm not lying about that. But then again, some people wouldn't think they were that good either. I thought they were awesome. I think they are. I think they're in my living room. Some of them I've sold, some of them I haven't. All just depends. I'm not looking for smoothness. I like the texture when the paint, I mean, it won't dry with this texture in it. You'll just see it in the finished product, the movement in the black, which I happen to like. So this little piece here, off in it, like that. And I will put some more black on there. As cheating. Because sometimes you got to put your palette on your painting and waggle it around some to make yourself happy. I'm so stupid. Okay. Alrighty there. Boy, that corner catcher's coming in handy for more than just catching corner paint. So digging this. I'll see if I can just get a little bit more of that to move off. I am going to, oh, I know what I could do. Excuse me for a second. I'm not going to change it. I'm just going to do with what I know works. Okay, let's see. Ooh, bubble. I don't like bubbles in the paintings. I do let my paints rest after I mix them, usually right after I first mix them. I don't like bubbles. Dee-dee-dee. See, what gets me, there's a whole bunch of paint sitting right underneath there. And this will take a while to dry. I don't care about that either. Got nothing but time. So. It's still moving. I am so digging the composition in this room. I love that copper. I'm sorry, that's not copper, it's rose gold. Thank you, Miss Annie from Annie's Art Channel. That is one talented woman. Congratulations on that 10 grand, baby. If somebody could let me know how this challenge thing works. I never can find where the original video is and who makes the challenge. Can somebody send me information on that? Please? I would appreciate it. And like I said, there's no right or wrong way, in my opinion, to do this. I know about archival and acid and all that kind of stuff as far as, but you know what? If my stuff's going to be archived, I'll be dead, and I won't care. So, there you have it. Right now, I use PVA and Floetrol because that's what I can afford. Okay, y'all. Let me get the camera down here in a second. I want to make sure I don't need to redon my gloves for any stuff. That looks good. Oh, it goes far right there. Done. Got a little white spot there. And here. Okay, it's okay, just paint. Okay. There is a lot of paint on this canvas. I could stand to lose some, but I don't want to. I just don't want to. I'm afraid I'm going to lose too much. I could probably move it back this way a little bit. But then I'm going to get rid of some cells, because I love these cells. They're amazing. What I'd like is to get that other corner covered. It just doesn't want to move. And I gotta watch these cells up here by my stomach. Come on. Okay, they're stretching them out. That I'm not digging that. It's moving. And I know what I can do. Yeah, I'm not done yet, folks. Apparently I'm not. My brain just will not wrap around the fact to leave it alone. I took an art class about 2 months back. Just once. 4 hours every Tuesday for 4 weeks, and it's through the Veterans Administration. Yeah, I'm a veteran. Oh, wait, can y'all see? Sorry if I'm in your way. And he told me, when you have to think about it, walk away. If you've already poured the paint, walk away. Stop thinking about it. And I haven't done that yet. I'm a harsh learner, hard learner, slow learner. I got paint all up. I did a painting one night, that big 3.5 foot by 3.5 foot. I got paint in my armpit. There was paint everywhere. It was so much fun to do. Okay, let me get y'all down. So you can see these cells. They're amazing. Absolutely amazing. Okay. Look at that. Look at those colors. That, my friends, is called acrylic flow technique, better known as pour, P-O-U-R, painting. And I am digging it. These colors are phenomenal. That there is going to be all copper. Sorry about the light. Let me get up out of our faces. There. Get my hand out of the way. Just hope I don't drop this on the painting. There we go. Sorry. I'm getting shadow, so hello. Yeah. Look at that. Yes, sorry, Bob Diddley. Okay, so let me show you the painting that I did earlier today. Here it is. A little strange, but still cool nonetheless. Okay, get my hand out of the way. This is my drying rack. And I'm in the process of packing too, because I'm moving in 2 weeks. There's some of the pendants that I've made. I don't know how well you can see them. But they're all done out of tree branches. Let's get a different view of this. Wow, that looks really, really good. I like it. And it's gonna stay that way. I like that composition. Okay, folks, thank you for sticking with it. Later.